and my two albums, new albums, in Berlin at the Hansa by the Wall studios. And I spent some time in the, just south of Cambodia, in Thailand. And I've just recently got back from Kenya. I just came here from Kenya. Where I took a straightforward corny safari.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But they still carry things on their hands in there.
Oh, yeah, I spent a little while, literally a few hours, with the Maasai tribe in Maasai Mara, which is western Kenya, just on the border of Tanzania.
Obviously, it must have been a lot of music.
Yeah. And it was...
a lot of percussion?
Absolutely, but I didn't actually go for the purpose of listening to the music too much. I went to really look at the lifestyle of the people, especially the Maasai tribe. They interested me very much, and I wasn't disappointed at all.
What was it about them?
Well, they've been living their particular way for at least untouched for at least about 800 years. I mean, it hasn't changed at all. And it took a long time to get permission to get to a village. I had to find a Maasai who spoke English, who worked in that area, who would get me into the village, because they're not particularly prone to white men. So yeah, it's very hard to get to see them. And I was fortunate enough to find a young guy who took me in. And they were very, very wary, very cautious of me in the beginning. But after a little while, they don't even speak Swahili. They still speak Maasai. And my two albums, new albums, in Berlin at the Hansa by the Wall studios. And I spent some time in the, just south of Cambodia, in Thailand. And I've just recently got back from Kenya. I just came here from Kenya. Where I took a straightforward corny safari.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But they still carry things on their hands in there.
Oh, yeah, I spent a little while, literally a few hours, with the Maasai tribe in Maasai Mara, which is western Kenya, just on the border of Tanzania.
Obviously, it must have been a lot of music.
Yeah. And it was...
a lot of percussion?
Absolutely, but I didn't actually go for the purpose of listening to the music too much. I went to really look at the lifestyle of the people, especially the Maasai tribe. They interested me very much, and I wasn't disappointed at all.
What was it about them?
Well, they've been living their particular way for at least untouched for at least about 800 years. I mean, it hasn't changed at all. And it took a long time to get permission to get to a village. I had to find a Maasai who spoke English, who worked in that area, who would get me into the village, because they're not particularly prone to white men. So yeah, it's very hard to get to see them. And I was fortunate enough to find a young guy who took me in. And they were very, very wary, very cautious of me in the beginning. But after a little while, they start to talk. They don't even speak Swahili. They still speak Maasai.